invited to no swell parties.
Because we're criminals. No. All right, Billy, how many more cases are they asking for?
Two.
Just two?
Yeah. Two.
Yeah.
Take them in, huh?
Okay, well, one of you's help me count.
All right, are you ready, Duke?
I think so.
No.
One.
And two.
Okie doke.
And what about the other 400 cases we got stashed on our ship? Billy, we've been docked here for 2 days and we barely unloaded any of them.
That's because the damn feds are swarming all over Manhattan! Dirty
scream! Hey, keep it down! You're one of the toughest bootleggers I know, but you gotta use your noggin here. We gotta find a safe place to store that stash until the heat calms down.
Hey! Some guys on my tail! I think he's a cop! I'll see you!
Take care of him, Billy!
Grab cab, go down to where the band is playing.
Well, hey,
fella!
And where do you think you're going?
Oh, I'm off to lead a life of wedding bliss. Well, but first, I'm gonna throw up a little bit. Hey, wait a minute. You're not a fella. Well, what's your name?
No, never you mind.
Well, never you mind. Busy as a beaver, you'll then. Hey, don't hit me! I'm wealthy.
Wealthy, huh? You wanna buy some more hoops?
Oh, no, no more hooch. I'm getting married tomorrow. Hurrah! You want to know why I'm getting married, never you mind?
Oh, because you love her.
No. I'm getting married to prove to Mother that I'm mature and responsible. That way, she'll let me take over the family business.
And what's the family business?
I don't know. Mother won't tell me.
All right, now you really gotta hightail out of here. I got work to do.
Oh, you're not falling in love with me, are you?
Oh, yeah. I never knew it could be this good.
Oh, please don't fall in love with me.
Hey, love's for suckers.
Well, then I'm a sucker with a swank Manhattan penthouse and a Long Island beach house that I never, ever, 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 ever use.
A Long Island beach house you never, ever, 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 ever use?
Well, yeah!
Oh, the one on Baby Lake.
What a good guess.
All right, now you're really gonna take it, power. I got work to do.
Oh, work? Ha! The man who only lives for making money lives a life that isn't necessarily sunny. Likewise, the man who works for fame, there's no guarantee that time won't erase his name.
I love drug-rich
people. The fact is, the only work that really brings enjoyment is the kind that is for girl employment. Fall in love, you won't regret it. That's the best work of all if you can get it.
All right, but some people that'll work for a living, okay?
Holding hands at midnight beneath the starry sky. Nice work if you can get it, and you can get it if you try. Strolling with the one girl, sighing, sigh after sigh. Nice work if you can get it, and you can get it if you try. Just imagine someone waiting at the cottage door, where two hearts become one. Who could ask for anything more? Loving one who loves you, and then taking that vow. Never you mind. Dance with me.
I don't know nothing about no dance.
Well, neither do I. Just follow the law. All right, now this man goes here.
What you got?
Nice work if you can get it, and you can get it if you try. Dee da 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 da. Dee ba ba da da. Nice work if you can get it. Get it if you try.
Where'd she go? Oh, hi!
Loving one. taking that vow. It's nice work if you can get it, and if you get it, won't you tell me how?
Hey, hey, hey. know, what do you say?
Okay, we're almost done filling the cellar, okay?
Okay.
Okay, hey, did you get rid of them two servants that was here?
Oh, yeah, I gave them each a case of the hooch and I told them to scram, okay?
Okay.
Okay, oh, okay, but why are you wearing that uniform?
Oh, yeah. In case the feds come snooping. Okay. Okay. And one last time, the Joker who owns this place.
He says he never uses it. Okay.
Okay. Okay. But I still don't understand. Why were you dancing with him?
Because I was undercover. Okay.
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 Okay. Okay. Okay. Listen, you toes. We gotta keep our heads here. The feds are really turning up the heat, and Brownbeard just sent us our biggest shipment of laughing syrup yet. So stop your yapping and go unload some more crates, okay?
Okay!
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 Okay, Mom's place.
Okay. How many rooms?
Oh, 47.
Oh, what a perfect little cottage.
Oh, boy. Who are you twos and what are you doing here?
Oh, well, you must be the butler the agency sent over.
Now, why would I be a butler? It's because I'm wearing a butler's uniform. Shut up!
I'm Jimmy Winter. This is my mother's beach house.
Wait, Jimmy Winter, I thought you never used this place.
Now then, servant, take these bags to my room.
Fetch it, sister!
Hey, how dare you talk to my wife that way?
Gypsy! I don't think this person realizes who he's in the presence.
Of course. See, this is Eileen Evergreen, the world's finest interpreter of modern dance. She's so advanced that when she gets on stage, no one has any idea what she's doing.
So then, little person, when we require you, with what name shall we beckon?
The name's Mickey, but my friends call me Cookie.
Cookie?
Eileen, who cares? It's our honeymoon.
Oh, Gypsy, kiss me!
Yes!
False alarm, I need breakfast first.
Muggy, have your wife make breakfast. Oh, and fast. Oh,
sure thing. Except I ain't married, but, sir.
That's odd. The agency telegrammed that you and your wife would arrive this morning.
Oh, right. Well, wouldn't you know it? Moments before you two's arrived. Well, Dave left me after years of wedded bliss. Oh, God!
You must have been devastated.
Oh, help me!
Muggy, I need to speak with you about my son.
Wait, what do you know about the show?
Can I trust you, Muggy?
Oh, sure.
All right, come. Okay. I may have a bottle of gin stashed in the cellar.
A whole bottle? Oh, shh! Leave it to me, boss. I won't even let you in the cellar.
Cookie person, aren't you forgetting something?
What?
Bags.
Right.
Right.
Eileen, the honeymoon begins.
First, I want you to swear to me that I'm the only woman you have ever worshipped.
Oh, I swear.
Even though you've been married 3 times before?
Well, see, Roxy, Trixie, and Ginger, they all meant nothing to me. And besides, what's important is that as of yesterday, Ginger was signing the annulment papers. I'm a free man.
Take me!
Yes!
No, wait! I need to bathe first. And then, this body, the most celebrated body in the American theater, you will be the first man to ever touch it.
Wait, really?
Give or take.
Oh, hey!
Jimmy, you're not supposed to be here!
I'm sorry, have we met?
Well, yeah, last night.
Oh,
that's when you told me you never ever used this place.
Oh, last night, boy was I lonely. Well, it's nice to see you again. I didn't catch your name.
Gertrude?
Oh, of course. Well, hey, Gertrude, do you mind if I help you with that crate?
Oh, no, it's just books.
Well, what are you, some college girl?
Yeah, right.
Well, which college?
Oh, the big one.
Big one.
With the Ivy.
Harvard.
Okay.
I was kicked out of Harvard. Also Yale and Rutgers and a couple others. I'm not very book smart.
Well, are you at least street smart?
No, I'm just rich and good looking. Turns out, that's enough. So, what brings you here anyway?
Oh, never you mind.
Hey, now I remember.
What do you remember?
I remember kissing you.
Never happened.
You sure?
Trust me, I ain't never been kissed.
How tragic. Do you know what you've been missing?
5 seconds of nothing.
Listen to me, Gertrude. I'm a mature and responsible married man now. So what I'm about to do is for complete educational purposes only. I promise you will derive absolutely no pleasure from this.
Wait, what are you going to do?
So, was it educational?
What
spotless uniform in case the feds come snooping. Of all the ideas I've ever had, does somebody want to get the door around here? Jumping pineapples!
All right, Butler, listen up. Chief Bartholomew Berry, LIPD. And I got inside info that dangerous bootleggers are hiding out in this neighborhood.
What? You know what they look like?
All we know is that they're ugly. You seen anyone like that?
Nope. Well, thanks for dropping by, officer.
Oh, servant! I see fear in your eyes. Well, fear not. You are safe here, for I will find them. And when I do, I will shoot them. And I will kill them. Well, have a nice day.
You too, officer.
Don't mind if I do.
Cookie!
Billy, did you just hear that, Flatfoot? He means business.
Yeah, and we gotta keep distracting everyone away from that cellar. Especially Jimmy Winter.
Oh, well, you know what distracts that guy more than anything?
What?
Dang.
Well, then we'll just get us a day.
Okay, where?
Oh, let's think.
Oh, I got it.
What?
You're a dame. Oh, no, I take that back. We need more of a kind of dame.
Cookie, please. I can be a kind of dame.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Cookie, I'll distract Jimmy Winter. Yeah, I'll give me some of them stockings. Ooh. I'll paint my mug. I'll slink around, sultry-like, and then I'll just distract him with my female stuff.
Okay, sounds like a pretty great plan, Billy.
Hey, get on this, ready?
Okay. Oh, is something wrong with your shoulder?
I got this.
Okay, you're gonna do great, kiddo.
Oh, McGee! Is there any sign of my wife?
Oh, no. Oh, hey. But this telegram just came for you.
Probably just a congratulations on the latest marriage. Once again, you have deeply disappointed me. It's from Mother. This isn't the way I've taught you to live, you simpleton. You've got your father's glorious profile. Fortunately, like him, you're also a complete imbecile. Love, Mother. Boy, McGee, do I miss her. Say, have you seen a funny kind of girl around here?
It depends. How funny?
Well, just different funny.
Oh, you mean Billy?
No, I don't think that was it. Say, I feel like a sandwich.
Oh, you know what? Me too. Hey, make me something with mustard.
Idea for a newlywed.
Aww. Okay, see you around then.
Bye. Well, hold on, ladies. You bring up an excellent cosmic dilemma. When I keep seeing things and going places, my life has come without your songs, without your friends and faces, it would be much duller. Whenever people step up to say, let's step tonight, if I've been low, I pep up again. Right. Whenever there's a party I can go to, it makes the world seem right. When music is playing and couples are swaying, say, I've got to be there, I've got to be there. When joy's in the making and ceilings are shaking and there's never a care, I've got to be there. Check my hat and throw the stuff away. I'm who's gone astray? Bottles are popping and dignity's dropping, and the women are fair. I've gotta be there. I've gotta be there.
You gotta be there.
Oh, ladies, thanks for dropping by.
done with our signs.
Oh, quick, girls, hide.
Oh, how will we know when the coast is clear?
Right. Just come out when you hear me say the word love. Finally, time for us to.
That's it. First, I want the little servant to ready our honeymoon boudoir. Biscuit! Biscuit!
It's cooking!
All right. And boss man, another telegram just came for you.
Really, Chips Ahoy? Now, was that any way to speak to your employer?
All right.
Mr. Employer, my sir, my lord, my master! Word of the most urgent nature came for thee
via the telegram peasant.
Hurrah! Hurrah! Hurrah!
Ginger didn't sign the annulment. She wants a bigger settlement.
You mean I married you while you were still married to someone else?
Not my Jean.
Oh my gosh. Our marriage is a sham.
A sham?
How dare you do this to the finest interpreter of modern dance in the world.
Now, wait.
You are a monster. You have placed me in
a compromising position.
You have made me the victim of a mock marriage.
The bubble house.
I'm in love with the butler.
I'm in love with the butler.
What?
Just some average Joe in disguise.
An average Joe?
Someone hiding right underneath our noses.
Under our noses?
Someone like you!
Like me?
No, you could never run a racket that size. You'd have to work
for a living.
Oh, McGee, I've read about people that work for a living.
Yeah. Well, good night, boss.
Love you.
Oh, I love you too.
Oh, McGee, that sounded like gunfire. McGee!
Don't move.
Ah, it's a girl.
And I've got a gun.
It's a girl with a gun?
And I know how to use it.
Ah, hands up.
It's not loaded.
Oh, I should have guessed.
I lied.
Ah! Holy mackerel, it's dirty. And you're packing a pistol, but why?
I just had to make sure this was your bedroom.
Oh, that's all right, I understand. Now, wait a minute. Why would you want to get into my bedroom?
To show you... this.
Oh, that's disgusting. Is there something wrong with your shoulder?
Didn't you hear that, ma'am? I'm a criminal.
Not to me, you're not. To me, you're You're just a hard-working girl that's putting herself through college. I've never met anyone like you before. Hey, Gertie, can I tell you something? Well, this afternoon when we kissed and I said I would derive no pleasure from it.
You derive pleasure? Well, how about that? Me giving someone pleasure. Well, would you like a little more pleasure?
Oh, well, yes, but if only I didn't have a wife.
Oh, yeah. Where is the dame anyway?
Oh, she got mad and left because she found out I was married to my other wife.
You have two wives.
I know.
I can just kick myself.
What kind of a man marries two women at one time? Are you going to marry me?
You're coming with me, sweetheart.
Oh, no, officer. You're making a terrible mistake.
Well, I'm betting this is the dame who just shot at me. And you two sure don't sound like honeymooners.
Oh, honey, tell them how much you love me.
Actually, officer, he's the one you should be arresting.
Oh, really helpful. You know something, officer? Lock her up.
Lock him up.
Lock her up. All we do is fight, and I'm sick of it. We're just too different. You know what I'm talking about?
Not really.
You say either, and I say either.
Huh?
You say neither, and I say neither. Follow along. Either, either, neither, neither. Let's call the whole thing off. Come on now. You like potato, and I like...
potato?
Yes!
You like tomato, and I like...
tomato.
Potato.
Potato.
Tomato.
Tomato.
Let's call the whole thing off.
Fine, it's off, and she's coming with me.
What? Oh! Call the whole thing off, then we must part. And oh, if we ever part, then that might break my heart.
So if you wear pajamas, then I wear pajamas. I wear pajamas and give up pajamas.
For we know we need each other, so we better call the calling off. Let's call the whole thing off.
Officer, I knew this girl was special the day we met.
Yeah, but then this jerk made me fall for him, even though he was already taken. Twice.
Once. So we got into this big fight, sort of like the one we're having now, until she let me explain myself. Remember my explanation, honey?
No.
Well, I said how you couldn't be mad at me for being married to other people when we hadn't even met yet. Why, if I'd met you first, you'd have been the only one I ever would have married. Easy.
You mean that?
Yeah.
Oh, hold on. That still don't solve your problem.
Officer, what problem?
You say laughter, and he says laughter. You say after, and he says higher.
Laughter.
Laughter. After. After. Let's call the whole thing off.
I like vanilla, and you like vanilla.
You sarsaparilla, and I sarsaparilla.
Vanilla.
Chocolate! Strawberry!
Let's call the whole thing off.
Thank you.
are you doing up here?
For Billy, she didn't come back to the boat last night.
That's because she's up here, scamming the mark, okay?
Hey, but I gotta tell you, this Playboy's got a pretty great setup. You should see the dames that walk through this place. Holy cow!
Dames make me nervous. I ain't no good with dames.
Well, that's just because you gotta know how to act around them.
Well, Billy tells me I should just act like myself.
Oh, buddy. That's the problem right there.
I'm looking for Jimmy. Is he still married?
Sweetheart, he's been married like 24 hours.
Which is 8 hours longer than his last marriage. I'll try that tomorrow.
Oh, hey, you seem like a pretty classy dame. Who's looking for a handsome fella to love?
And what's it to a tiny little butler like you?
It's not for me. It's for my friend.
Sorry, not interested.
Oh, that's too bad. Hey, Duke.
Duke? Duke of what?
Nah, you see, it's just that my name
is... The Duke of England!
What?
That's right! Duke of England. Please meet
you. Oh, the very available Miss Jeannie Muldoon. A pleasure.
Wait a minute.
So tell me, Duke, you looking for a duchess?
Wait a minute!
A duchess is just what this Duke needs. But the girl can't be any regular dame. After all, one day, if the right people die, they could become king and, dare I say it, queen of England.
What? Oh my God! I always wanted to be queen of England.
Well, there you go. It looks like you two have a lot of talking to do. I'll see you.
Cookie!
Bye!
I get nervous around dames.
Oh, ain't no reason to get nervous around me, Duke. Happen to calm you down, I just give you a little serenade.
No thanks, I'm thirsty.
Fine, you wanna cut to the chase? Let's cut to the chase.
What chase?
Well, that's it, you big strong brute. Have your way with me. Yes, no, yes, no, I won't. I will, I won't, I will. Oh, why you?
What?
What did you do to me?
Nothing.
Two lips were pressed to
But you! It was you!
When you ask.
Hey, Billy, I've got great news. All is safe and sound in the cellar. Hey, how'd that distracting go?
Oh, fantastic. I distracted him the whole night.
Whoa, 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 you didn't go and do anything?
No, we mostly just talked. He told me all about his life as a wealthy playboy. Oh, and I told him all about mine. As a bootlegging honor student from Harvard.
Okay, say that last part again.
You know, he's really not that bad of a guy.
You ain't going to get feelings for him, are you?
What? I mean, no. I'm the professional here.
McGee, my breakfast.
All right, I'm coming, I'm coming. And keep your pants on for once in your life. All right, well, I'm scrambling Valentino's eggs. Do you want to give him this telegram? It's from a ginger.
Hey, that's one of his wives.
Are you listening to yourself? One of his wives?
Ginger, sign the annulment papers.
And what's that got to do with you?
Nothing. I'm just, you know, happy for him.
Oh, I'm getting a bad feeling about this, Billy.
No, oh, Cookie, come on. I'm doing what I'm doing for the gang here. I distracted him last night, and tonight I'm going to distract him again.
And what happens when he finds out the truth? Billy, I know you. You're smart. You're shrewd. And you've got the tenacity of an Irish priest in a bar. Don't let this guy turn you into an idiot.
You sarsaparilla and I sarsaparilla. Well, there's my girl.
Hey, Jimmy, I gotta ask you something. All those pretty things you said to me last night, were they just lies?
Oh, I would never lie to you, Gertie. Just like I know you would never lie to me, right?
Right. About that, do you remember last night when I told you the whole truth about me?
Well, yeah.
Well, the whole truth is only partly true.
Oh, thank goodness. You're not a wanted felon.
No, that's the true part. See, my name's not Gertrude.
It's not?
It's Billy. Billy Bendix. And I come from a long line of nothing. I never went to no Harvard. And I got a couple of cases of gin stashed in your cellar. Jimmy,
to tell you the truth, I suspected you never went to Harvard.
You did?
There's no girls at Harvard.
You crow. Why didn't you say nothing?
Well, because I was afraid if I did, I'd never see you again. Billy, I'm not exactly certain if I have one wife or two wives, but if you'll agree to be my fourth, or maybe it's fifth wife, well, I promise you, you'll be the one I'm with for the rest of my life. Life has just begun. Jack has found his Jill. Don't know what you've done, but I'm all athrill. How can words express your divine appeal? You can never guess all the love I feel. From now on, lady, I insist. For me, no other girls exist. It's wonderful. It's marvelous. You should care for me. Some love, spare a dime. It's what I love to do.
Right there.
What doesn't matter? Do all these servants
What is this about Mr. Winter not being married anymore?
This telegram arrived for you this morning, sir, from Mrs. Ginger.
Ginger got the money I wired her. She signed the annulment.
Why, this is splendid news. Now we can have the wedding this very afternoon.
Oh, yay!
No, this afternoon? Wouldn't it be better to wait?
Oh, nonsense! And I will personally plan the wedding function myself. Catered, of course, by, Chef Drew!
No!
Something has come up since last night.
Well, I hope this has to do with your responsibility to marry my daughter.
Well, that's just it, sir. See, this woman here...
Your cockney maid?
Yes, sir. Well, I mean no, sir. It's...
Bobby Billy is not our cockney maid?
No. Well, I mean she's just...
If you're having cold feet, perhaps we should just contact your mother.
Oh, no, not my mother. Anyone but her. I'm sorry, but... I can't.
You can't what?
What I think Master Jimmy is trying to say is that he can't do nothing but marry a daughter. And anyone who thinks otherwise is just kidding us off. Ain't that right, sir?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, as we Cockney people like to say, cheers.
What an enchanting maid you have here, James. Aren't foreigners that speak English just delightful? We don't need to build a wall.
Oh, it's wedding time! Come, feisty butler, I will show you where the good shrine of his store is. I believe it's in the cellar.
No! You can't go in there!
None of you can!
Of course we can't! Right, Daddy?
Men to the cellar! Come on, girls, let's go!
Bonnie in the cellar!
Everybody move away from this door!
Daddy, I don't understand!
Cause why?
Cause the master has something to say.
Wait, I do?
You do?
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Are you positive?
I'm positive.
Well, maybe I forgot.
I don't think you did.
I think you have something to say.
I do?
You do.
Are you sure?
Oh, enough with this song and dance.
Wait, say that again?
Enough with this song and dance.
That's it.
Got a little rhythm, a rhythm, a rhythm. That bit of hats through my brain. So darn persistent, the day isn't distant when it'll drive me insane.
In the morning without any warning, hands around me all day.
Someday I'll speak up to it, and then I'll speak up to it. I hope it listens when I say.
Fascinating rhythm, you got me on the go. Fascinating rhythm, I'm all equipped. What a mess you're making, the neighbors want to know why I'm always shaking, just like a flipper. Each morning I get up with a sun. Fine at night, no work has been done. I know that once it didn't matter, but now you're doing wrong when you start to chatter. I'm so unhappy. Don't you take the day off, decide to run along somewhere far away off and make it snappy. Oh, how I want to be the man I used to be. Fascinating rhythm, I won't stop picking on me.
Well, that was rather amusing, but the seller
got a little rhythm.
All right, ladies, help me out.
Got me on the go.
Got me on the go.
Got a little rhythm. Got me on the go.
Yeah.
Back there, because that means I gotta spend some more time with my family, and I'm not doing that. Now we got a plan to do, and we're gonna do it. Got it?
Got it.
Got it? I heard you, I heard you. Dead people heard you.
But we have frightfully little time to plan for this afternoon's nuptials. So listen up. Perfection is required.
Oh boy.
Now you and Bobby Billy will be in charge of the food and drink. Go, spirits.
What? No booze at a wedding? Who's gonna come?
Silence, and as for the music!
Oh, the music. Okay, don't even talk to me about the music. I know just the gang to bang it out for you.
Gang, I think not. We will be hiring these string quartets.
String quartets? Put people to sleep. Now, would you like to hear some red hot rhythms, the latest sounds, the biggest wow on every stage in New York City?
I'd rather die.
I'd like to help you.
Butler, you know what they put on stage nowadays? Frothy comedies, frivolous boy meets girl, sex farces, and the music. Don't even talk to me about the music. Away with the music of Broadway. Be off with your Irving Berlin. Oh, I give no quarter to Colonel Comport, and Gershwin keeps pounding on tin. How can I be sinful when hearing this rule? It's only for nightclubbing sexes. Who cares if how strictly she wants that his Viennese? And go tell the man if they want a hand.
Four quarter.
My turn.
I was afraid you might have left.
And why would you care about that?
Listen to me. I have to marry Aileen today. Otherwise, the Senator Reverend Judge, he'll throw me in jail. But don't worry, I've come up with a plan.
A plan?
To stop my wedding.
Look, I fell for your pretty tug of tricks once, and I ain't about to fall for them again.
And how's the happy honeymooners?
Oh, you know, we're fine, officer, but we could have some honeymoon privacy.
Oh, sure. But first I need to take a little peek in your cellar.
What?
What for?
Oh, it's just standard. Say, what's your wife doing wearing a maid's uniform?
I just like to dress up. For fun, right, honey?
Right, for fun.
Oh, sure. The ex-missus and I used to do that all the time. Good times, good times. Well, I'll give you two kids some privacy, but first, may I?
Oh, sure.
These are pretty good. Oh, yeah, I'm taking for evidence.
All right, officer. Thanks for getting me out of that real jam.
Don't forget it for you. You had a chance with me, and you blew it.
Well, if you really feel that way, then what are you still doing around here?
I got a job to do, and it ain't none of your business anyway.
Boy, you screaming at me sure brings back memories.
From when?
Yesterday. I remember the bliss of that wonderful kiss. I knew that a boy could never feel more joy from any little miss. I remember it quite. It was a wonderful night. Oh, how I'd adore it if you would encore it. Bum ba bum ba bum ba bum dee dum bum da 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 dee ba dee da do 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 what you done done done. Baby, oh do 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 what I do 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 adore. Baby, let's try again, sigh again, fly again to heaven. Baby, see, it's ABC. I love you and you love me. I don't know what a whoa baby. So don't say it won't come true. Dum-dum-dum-dum. So do-do-do what you've done-done-done before. Bum-ba-bum-ba-bum-dee-dum-boo-bum-doo. Ba-do-ba-dee-doo-ba-doo-bee-doo. Won't you do-do-do. Won't you do-do-do. What you done-done-done before. What-do-what-do-what-do-what. Ziggy-boop, ziggy-boop, do. So do do do, won't you do what? Happy my heart begins to sigh. Ba-doy-dee-doy-dah. Thanks, fellas.
Daughter, who I am finally marrying off. Thank you.
Soup's on! And now a special company tribute to everybody's favorite gentleman group.
There's no need for that.
Whoopsies, the banging around you. Hanging around you, hanging around you. Dearie, I never know just where I stand. Shut it!
Salad,
but we haven't.
You're cussing yet.
My apologies, sir.
There!
You touched it. Oh, you touched it again now.
Thanks, Ghost, coming right on.
Oh, is that Charlie Chaplin?
Where? Where?
Oh, no, my false alarm, I'm sorry.
Wanted to meet him, too.
You know, I hear he's a communist.
Oh! Seems hanging around me. Oh! Hanging around me. Hanging around me. Mommy.
Dearie, you want to learn, you want to learn.
Cat run past and turn the salmon in his mouth.
He went that away.
I got the salmon.
I got the cat.
With this common cockney maid.
Well, it's not that simple.
Ah, don't tell them nothing, pretty boy.
Julia.
Me likey the cockney chickie. Here's to you, honey bun.
Julia, I believe you're drunk.
It's impossible. I'm the proud founder of the Society for Dry Women.
Oh, that's an unfortunate name.
Cheers!
Estonia, stop at this instant.
No! Why should I? I'm a grown woman.
Well, you're certainly not acting like a grown woman.
Oh my gosh, he's right. My papa's big brother, he's right. I am just
thank you. James Winter, you have given us the worst wedding luncheon ever.
Oh, Daddy, it wasn't his fault.
It's all her fault.
Bobby, Billy, you will pack your things and go.
All right, let's get this wedding done with before I change my mind. Come on, Eileen.
I'm just an average mug from Jersey. Well, I was named Duke after our family dog. But all that doesn't matter, see? All that matters is...
Duke in the kitchen, okay?
Okay.
Best bum you ever had, huh?
Well, yeah.
Wow.
Now that I am starting, I cannot deny I prefer to see you later to a mere goodbye. But before departing, do I hope it fades? Something makes me wonder whether you'll forget me altogether if we never meet again. When you go your way, out through my doorway, will you remember me? But when you're lonesome, I'd like to also place in your
cases of gin in my cellar.
That's right. And now you're coming with us.
Oh, Gypsy, say this isn't true.
Oh, it's true, all right. Except this here's Duke Mahoney.
I knew it.
And that there's Cookie McGee, two of Brownbeard's most notorious henchmen. And I've been playing dumb, see? Waiting for one of them to lead me to the big boss himself.
Great plan.
Grab him, boys.
Oh, wait, wait! Stop the arrestor!
Genie!
Oh, if this big world head goes to jail, I'm going with him!
Young lady, what is the meaning of this?
There is a route and a rider. And I'll never get to ride in a carriage and wave to my subjects. Oh, but don't you see? All that doesn't matter. All that matters is...
about to explode.
Cookie, you know what that means.
Basement. Oh, face it, Max. Prohibition is just a stupid law made by stupid politician telling grown adults they can't drink what they like. Indeed. You might as well ban laughter, or music, or making love on the beach.
No one better make love on this beach.
Oh. Too late.
Oh, Max. Don't you remember when we were young and we made love on a beach?
Oh, I never made love on any beach.
That's true, but you tried.
You can't speak to me like that. Why, I am a senator, reverend judge, and now I am
beyond indignation.
I am beyond indignation, and now I am
bursting with outrage.
I am bursting with outrage. And above all else, I'm in love with the butler. I'm in love with the butler.
Thank you.
Wait, where are you going?
I'm going back to the boat, and I hope you enjoy your marriage to that dancing day.
But I didn't marry Eileen today.
What?
Billy, I'm a new man. I no longer care what my mother thinks. Notice how I didn't even bring her along.
Jamie?
Well, that was the plan anyway. Billy, this is my mother.
And I'm his daddy.
What?
And mother, this is Billy Bendix. The love of my life and best bootlegger in the business.
A bootlegger?
I know you're ashamed of me, mother. So disinherit
me. Oh, Jamie, shut up for a moment.
No, for we will live like poor people. We'll draw our own baths. We'll make our own lunch. We'll move to Wisconsin. All money is good for is buying big homes and fancy cars and delicious food, but can't you see? Billy Bendix means so much more to me than all that. I might be poor, but for the first time in my life, I'm happy, Mama.
Oh, Jamie, I'm not going to disinherit you.
Oh, thank God. That sounded awful.
My dear, are you really a bootlegger?
And I am ashamed.
And why should you be? I'm a bootlegger, too.
Mother!
Oh, wake up and smell the Irish coffee, Jamie. How else do you think we can afford a 47-room beach house? Not only am I a bootlegger, son, say hello to Brownbeard.
Mother!
Millicent, you're the most wanted felon on the East Coast?
That's me.
Wow, what a woman.
Wait, lady, you're saying that you're mine.
Your boss, yes. And I've heard such wonderful things about you, Billy Bendix. So I would be honored if you'd be my son's fourth and hopefully final wife.
Boy, am I just glad I didn't marry my sister.
What?
So, how about it, Billy?
Well, no.
Did you just say no?
Look, I can't marry him. Every time I get near this joker, I just make one stupid decision after another.
Oh, my dear, that's what love does. It turns perfectly rational women like us into complete idiots. Take a look at Max here. Though charming to look at, he's a pompous moralist with limited intellectual capacity. He had no choice but to go into politics. As for me, I followed my foolish heart with what I wound up with, my darling Jamie. And now, I need a successor.
Wait, you want me to take over the family business?
Don't be an ass! I want Billy to take over the family business.
Yeah, that's probably better.
Lady, I'd be happy to be a new Brownbeard.
Son, I would like to give you my seat in the United States Senate.
I don't know, that sounds like a lot of work.
No, it's the Senate.
Oh, well, then sure. So how about it, Billy? I'll be one of the highest-ranking politicians in Washington, and you'll be doing something important. Let me be the last bad decision you ever make. And this world would be like heaven if she followed my lead.